In this tutorial, I want to show you how we can format a date to a different format so that you can, for example, use it inside emails. And then instead of like having like a long date string that doesn't look so nice, we have actual words that say something like, hey, the 15th of July, something like that. So let's just dive right in and then I'll explain how it works. So the example that I want to show you is this. So I'm using Calendly to handle all of my online appointments so people can pick a spot inside my calendar, and then boom, this scenario is going to start. And then in this example, I'm going to send a confirmation email to that person that just booked it. So it will send to the person who booked the call, and then the subject is details about our call. And then in the content, I want to write, hey, first name, thanks for booking a call with me. And then I want to mention when that call is. So what I want to do is I will say something like, I will see you on the, and then I want to say the date. But here I have the start time variable from this module that is getting all the info about this event. But you will see if I do this, I will see you on the, and then start time, looking forward on the, then it's going to look a bit weird. So here, if I say run once, then I'm going to schedule an event. I'll click here. Okay. I will pick a time. Then I will fill this out. Emma Doe, here just some sample data. And then we go over here. Then right now we are getting the event or the data from that event. Okay, this is the data that we got. Then it got the start time over here of the call. Then the email was sent. So now if we go over to the inbox, then you see that we get the email here, but it says here, I will see you on the, and then we have this really long like date, time, string, which really doesn't look so nice, right? We want to humanize that a bit. We want to make that look like it was actually written by a person. So to do that, what we can do is we can use the formatDate function. You can find that under this calendar icon. Then over here we have a formatDate. And what we can basically do is we can give it a date from, for example, a variable from a previous module, and then we can format it to a different format that we specify with date and time tokens. So over here, I will put in formatDate, and then I want to say, I see you on the, and then here before the semicolon, I want to say, okay, we want to grab start time, and we want to format this to, and then we go to the tokens for date and time formatting. I will also put this page in the description below so that you can check it out. It's really handy. I just personally bookmarked this myself so that I can always find it quickly. So then I want to say the date of the month with the ordinal. I'm not sure if you pronounce this word ordinal, ordinal, I'm not sure. But so we need this DO. So I copy this DO and we paste it in here. So right now it will say, I will see you on the 15th, for example. Now then we just want to type the word off, and then we put in another format date. And then I want to give it the month name. But first, again, put in the start time. Then I want to put the month name so that we look that up. So here, month name is 4 times M in capitals. Then I will put it in here. Then it will say, I will see you on the 15th of June. Explanation mark. Okay, click save. Then we click run once. And then we are going to schedule it again to see what it looks like right now. So I will fill this out again. Here, I pick a spot. Okay, schedule event, and then we're going to get the data here. Email has been sent. Go over to the inbox, then here show, we have a new email. So here you see this right now, it says, hey Emma, thanks for booking a call with me. I will see you on the 24th of June. This looks way nicer than this over here, right? Now then what you can also do is you can even include a time. So we can, for example, also say, I will see you on the 15th of June at, and then we want to include a time. So then we're going to format it again, format date. Then we will again put in the variable of the start time. And then after the semicolon, we want to put in the hours and then also the minutes. So I'm using the 24 hour time myself because I'm from Europe, but if you would want to use the 12 hour time, then that is also possible. Then you just use a different token for that. But so 24 hour, and I want to do it with a leading zero. So I do HH in capital, and then I do a colon, and then I want to look for minutes. So minutes over here, minutes with leading zero, 2 times M in lowercase. Okay, now here I remove the space, looking forward to it. Click OK, click Save, click Run once. Then we're going to test it again, see if it works right now. Go back, pick a spot. Okay. Then we're going back over here. And the email was sent. Let me go back to the inbox. So here you see that right now it says, "Hey Emma, thanks for booking a call with me. I will see you on the 30th of June at 9:30. Looking forward to it." So yeah, I hope that this helped you to understand how you could format the date. So in this case, I'm just doing this inside an email, but you can do this for all kinds of different things inside different modules, right? If you have any questions about this, just let me know in the comments below.